right behind.
There we are. Ready to go. Yeah, we're on.
Okay, good evening, everyone. Welcome. Okay. So we got that part out of the way. All right, let's call this meeting to order. If you stand, we'll have our invocation and our pledge of allegiance. Let's pray, please. Heavenly Father, we're grateful for the day and for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. We pray tonight that you would lend us just a little of your wisdom as we deliberate the issues of our city. We pray for our citizens, for their health, for their strength, for all of those things, Heavenly Father, that may be troubling them at this time in their life, this time in the economy that we're in. We ask that you would just lend them a touch from your hand. Lord, we just ask all of these blessings in the name of your Son. Amen.
United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All righty, first item on our agenda is a closed session. If someone would move us into that, I'd appreciate it.
Mr. Mayor, I move the council go into closed session. Subject being in personnel matters, specifically the interview of candidates for appointment to Poquoson School Board, pursuant to Section 2.2, TAC 3711, Alpha 1, the Code of Virginia.
Okay, thanks, sir.
Second.
All right, we have a motion made and seconded. We go to closed session. Any concerns, comments? If not, Ms. Kim?
Councilman Southall?
Aye.
Vice Mayor Freeman?
Aye.
Councilman Hucks?
Aye.
Councilwoman Fox?
Aye.
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 Councilwoman Andrews?
Aye.
Aye.
Mr. Mayor, the motion carried by a vote of 7-0.
All righty. Thank you, ma'am.
case I have to walk to the board.
That's what happens when you have...
Do you want me to sing?
Hello?
Ooh, oh! Nice.
That is nice.
If that doesn't come across when I'm doing my minutes, I'm striking you out.
Hello?
Hello?
Okay.
That'll be there.
We're ready to go. Yep.
Okay. All right. We are reconvened from our closed session. We need to certify that, please.
Yeah, I move we certify that, to the best of each member's knowledge, only public business matters lawfully exempted from the open meeting requirements by Virginia law were discussed in the closed session.
Okay. Second. All right. We have a motion made second that we certify our closed session. Comments, concerns, any questions? If not, Ms. Kim.
Councilwoman Andrews.
Aye.
Councilman Fye.
Aye.
Councilman Southall.
Aye.
Vice Mayor Freeman.
Aye.
Councilman Hucks.
Aye.
Councilwoman Fox.
Aye.
Mayor Hessel.
Aye.
Mr. Mayor, the motion carried by a vote of 7-0.
All right, thanks, Kim. Let's move on to our audience visitors. If there's anyone in the audience who'd like to address council on any issue, we'd be delighted to hear from you at this time. Okay, she doesn't want to talk. All right. Okay. Let's move on to the approval of minutes, regular session, January 9, 2023, please.
Mayor, I move that the council adopt the minutes of the regular session held on 9 January 2023 as submitted.
All right. Thanks, sir.
Second.
All right. Motion made second. We adopt the regular session minutes from January 9, 2023. Any concerns, additions, any questions regarding the minutes? If not, Ms. Kim.
Councilman Fye.
Aye.
Councilwoman Andrews.
Aye.
Councilwoman Fox.
Aye.
Vice Mayor Freeman.
Aye.
Councilman Southall.
Aye.
Councilman Hucks.
Aye.
Mayor Hessel.
Aye.
Mr. Mayor, the motion carried by a vote is 7-0.
Okay, thanks, Kim. We have one public hearing tonight. It is a pre-budget hearing, something that we do every year at about this same time. It has to do with fiscal year 2024. Any questions, any comments before we open the public hearing? Okay, we don't hear any, so we will open a public hearing and ask if there's anyone that would like to address that issue. I see none. We'll close the public hearing and move on to item number two, a request for a conditional use permit by Matt Booth and Lynn Howard, Overflow LLC, for operation of a tourist home to be located at 430 With Creek Road, tax map number 27-1-114, zone B2, business/commercial.
No, I think Mr. Cannella is going to present for staff. As Mr. Cannella comes up, or is the applicant unable to join us tonight?
I don't see him.
Cool. Good evening, Thomas.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of council. As was read before you tonight, is a request for a conditional use permit by Matt Booth and Lynn Howard of Overflow LLC for the operation of a tourist home to be located at 430 With Creek Road. The consideration of the city code, Mr. Mayor, is that the zoning ordinance defines a tourist home as a dwelling in which overnight accommodations are provided or offered for three or more transient guests. We define what a tourist home is. However, it is not a permitted use in any zoning district within the city. Legal notice and adjacent letter information presented. About the use, per the application, is for a tourist home, fully furnished and outfitted home for lodging for 1 to 30 consecutive nights. Again, our city code definition for tourist home. This is a proposed site, Mr. Mayor, 430 With Creek Road, tax map parcel 27, TAC 1, TAC 114. It is zone B2 business commercial. It's a single family home built in 1949, so it's been there for quite a while. It was recently renovated. I'm sure you are all familiar with the site near 7-Eleven, across the street from McDonald's and Rite Aid. I have copied, as part of the presentation, the permitted uses in the B2 district, like I did for the last conditional use permit application. I won't go through them, but if anybody has any questions or would like to see the slide again, I'll come back. And of course, the use is permitted only by a conditional use permit. Like I mentioned earlier, this is not one of those. That slide continued. So, Mr. Mayor, the consideration that should be given to the comprehensive plan as it relates to this application, Section 8-30 of the comp plan does address the future land use within the central planning districts, which this is a part, and it reads,
as well as new development of commercial properties, redevelopment of commercially zoned land along With Creek Road is encouraged. Residential development in the Central Planning District will vary according to the property's location, access, attributes, and future land use designation, ranging from family subdivisions, formerly planned subdivisions, clustered open space subdivisions, to moderate and high density developments. In reference to the With Creek corridor specifically, Section 8, Tac 34 of the comp plan says, With Creek Road is the primary commercial corridor in Poquoson, with commercial establishments fronting the eastern and western sides of the roadway from the Oxford Run Canal to Poquoson Fire Station 2. Both sides of With Creek Road have been developed with a variety of commercial structures reflecting multiple architectural styles and designs. The shape of the With Creek commercial corridor, as well as the intensity of commercial uses, is expected to remain constant, aside from infill development or redevelopment of existing properties. This is the future land use map, as found in the comprehensive plan. It's small, but you can see generally where this property is located, indicated by the white arrow there, which future land use designation is general commercial. Recommended conditions for your consideration, Mr. Mayor, is that the business will be subject to all applicable taxes as determined by the Commissioner of Revenue, to include a transient occupancy tax at the time of implementation. All signage shall be subject to architectural review. The use must comply with all state, local, and federal permits, licenses, etc. If at any time the specified permitted use on the property is discontinued for a period of 2 or more years, the permit shall become null and void. At no such time shall more than 2 persons per bedroom occupy the dwelling. The 6th is that parking for the use shall be accommodated for on-site in a paved driveway and or parking area as approved by community development staff. Parking spaces shall be provided at a rate of 1 per unit and 1 per bedroom. And of course, that City Council reserves the right to review and amend the conditions of the permit as they see fit. It was recommended for your approval by the Planning Commission, and I am happy to answer any questions that you all may have.
All right, Thomas, well done. Number one, questions?
Yep, got a couple. Do you know if they have any plans for the adjacent lot? There's a little teeny strip of land that goes back to about 1.6 acres behind or to the east of that, owned by the same company. Do they have any kind of plans for that?
I believe, as I thought I heard you state, that it is owned by the applicant.
Right.
I believe that is still the case. We had a series of meetings with them last year. They were interested at the time
to put a
house on that lot. There are some environmental restrictions, but the use of the lot to the rear, they've expressed, will be for a residence.
Yeah, it's a long, skinny lot. I just wondered, because it's the same company, if they would plan on. Okay, second question is, you mentioned that, of course, the thing about signage will be in accordance with. Do they have any plans for any kind of sign in front of this place?
At this time, they don't, but we wanted to make sure that it was explicitly clear in the permit that if they just wanted to have a sign, it would be subject to architectural review.
Okay, and parking. I understand it's right now a 3-bedroom.
It's a 4-bedroom.
It's a 4-bedroom?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
It is.
So that would be 4 cars plus 1 for the structure itself? You have as many as 5 cars?
A total of 5 spots.
Whoa.
Do you know if they plan on expanding the pavement or?
Well, this site in particular has a small driveway that they could fit about 2 cars in. You can kind of see it here. But under those trees in the rear of the property is also a paved area, and the applicant expressed no concern with having to meet the requirements as recommended to you all.
Okay, well, it looked like that the curb is cut on both sides of the house where it could be a circular, and I'm wondering if pulling onto With Creek instead of backing onto With Creek would be a better option.
Well, and there is room in the rear for cars to turn around and use the same curb cut if necessary. But, the curb cut between this house and 7-Eleven is also serves the property of the applicant. So, you know, if an easement was necessary, that work would be easy to accomplish. But if not, there's room here to accommodate turning around in the rear of this house and being able to come out onto Wythe Creek Road and not back out.
I have two questions.
Sure.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did anybody respond to any of the notices that were sent out, number one? And number two, say persons, two per bedroom, if there was a couple with a baby, would that baby count? Like if the, you know, some friends wanted to go and one of the couples in the bedroom had a baby, does that baby or small child count against the number?
The real intent, you know, was so that homes with, let's say, three bedrooms didn't put two or three beds in each bedroom and then have an overwhelming number of people stay. I don't think we would necessarily consider a small child as part of that, but I don't foresee issues with the cap. I know the applicant didn't express any, so I don't think that would necessarily count towards an overall number of persons.
And did anybody respond? Weren't notices sent out? Did anybody?
Notices were sent, and there was no response from any adjacent property owner. Yes, sir.
Other questions to Thomas? Go ahead, boy.
If this gets approved, is this for that business only?
It is for this parcel only. It's site-specific conditional use permit. It would only be for this property.
Not be extended to any residential area?
It would not. It is for this site and this site only.
I don't think it operates anymore, but there used to be a B&B right up the road from that. Is that a similar situation? Did they have a conditional use permit?
I think at one time, but that operated as a bed and breakfast, but hasn't operated in probably the better part of a decade.
Is this the first structure of its kind or first of its kind in the city?
It is the first application we have received for a tourist home or short-term rental, whatever. They're fairly interchangeable, but yes, it's the first application we've received for one.
Okay, because I was looking at the resolution, which has yet to be read, but I'm in favor of putting a 2-year limit on it, so we can readdress it in 2 years automatically.
What is the difference between a tourist home and, say, like the B&B that stay on the street?
We used tourist home because we have a definition for it, but we don't have a definition for short-term rental. And there may be, I think it's probably more definitional than it is really practice that separates a tourist home from a bed and breakfast. A tourist home really just has to accommodate the stay, not necessarily the lodging, not necessarily the stay, if that makes sense.
So this is essentially going to be like an Airbnb?
Correct. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Everybody said what a tremendous improvement that is on that corner.
They did a good job.
Irregardless of what it becomes.
And yeah. Do we know, sorry, one more question. Can multiple, is it an, because on some Airbnb, house, do we know or do we care?
This is a whole house rental.
A whole house rental.
That's how it's been presented.
Okay.
All right, anyone else?
Mr. Mayor, I propose a resolution to approve a conditional use permit for the operation of a tourist home to be located at 130 Wythe Creek Road, tax map parcel 27-1-114. Zone B2, business commercial.
Okay.
Second.
All right, there's a motion made second that we...
I'd like to amend that to for 2 years, if that's possible. Okay. I don't know how we do that, if you just add that.
You just add it to that.
Add an additional condition.
Okay, and the condition of it for 2 years, so it will be till 31 January of 2025.
Okay, I can't. I'm not going to agree with the 2 years, but that's just me. I don't know what the point. I don't know what the point is in that.
Yeah, but
we did.
I did. Missed it.
That's not this part.
We have to do the amendment now, Wayne.
But on the amendment first.
Yeah, the proposed amendment.
Do you have a second?
We don't have
the
a
amendment
second yet.
I second. I think it's a good idea because we don't know where this is going.
All right. Okay. We have a motion made and seconded. We add a 2-year clause there. To readdress that at that time. So, Kim, would you please?
Councilwoman Fox?
Aye.
Councilman Hucks?
Please excuse me if I'm out of order, but this is a spur of the moment thing, and I would appreciate being able to have a discussion on the amendment and the potential unintended consequences of our other repercussions that might come from that. So I know we have a motion on the table, and as I said, please excuse out of order, but
we had a motion.
Well, I much prefer to have some time to consider the potential unintended consequences of the amendment. A chance to deliberate it more than making a
okay. Get
motion on the floor that's been seconded and you started the roll call.
On the amendment. We're on the amendment.
But I don't think you could interrupt the.
Okay, very good. Very good.
Would the discussion have been first before we.
No, we're going to vote on the amendment right now. Kim, please.
Councilman Hucks?
No.
Councilman Fye?
Yes.
Councilman Southall?
No.
Councilwoman Andrews?
Aye.
Vice Mayor Freeman?
Aye.
Mayor Hessel?
No.
Mr. Mayor, the motion carried by a vote of 4-0.
Okay. 4-3.
4-3, sorry. I'm so used to saying zero.
Okay. Let's go back to the original request, please. We've done the amendment. We need to do the request for the conditional use permit. Kerry, you want to do that again?
Okay, we need to do it again?
Yep.
Okay, let me turn the page. Mr. Mayor, I propose a resolution to approve the conditional use permit for the operation of a tourist home to be located at 130 With Creek Road, tax map partial 27-1-114, zoned B2, business commercial, as amended.